My destiny, been out and I dress in trees. I'm not worried about back and forth. Made a mortgage from House and Beats. The devil, you balcony. Got a chopper, I never squeeze. No, I holla, I play with keys. And my drummer, brought at your feet. But back to that rapper shit. The backpack, not that trapping shit. I'm a dick.
How y'all doing, family? This is Chris Rod with Media TV, and I'm gonna be coming to you with this news. My brother Jamal Bey always sending me something, man. The brother always sending me something. So big ups to that brother. So I'm going to be coming to you from the Yahoo News. It says China military tells Russia, we've come to support you against the U.S. So family, y'all know, I don't know if y'all heard, but you remember the tariffs and stuff like that that's going on right now? U.S. put $50 billion on U.S. tariffs, and then China came back and did like $3 billion. And then the U.S. came back and put like, what, $103 or $1,200 or something like that. And then China came back and did $50 to $60 billion. So it's, and the new tariffs that China put on the U.S. that's going to be upcoming is the automobile, airplanes, and other shit like that. And that's going to take a big toll on the U.S. But the U.S. is so fucking stupid because China owns the U.S. The U.S. debt, $21 or $23 trillion debt that the U.S. have. And China own that shit. You feel what I'm saying? And China have more businesses and everything and more wealth economy than any other fucking any other fucking country. So you going to war with them is not the fucking right idea to do. China is trying to buy everything in the U.S. Damn, they own the U.S., but they trying to buy everything, like the stock exchange and shit like that. So this shit just going to keep getting worse and worse and worse. This shit going to keep getting worse and worse, family. But I'm about to get into this article. This article was published by Tom O'Connor. By the Newsweek, published on April 3rd, 2018. It says, China military leadership has pledged its support to Russia as tensions between Moscow and the West further deteriorates in diplomatic isolation, economic sanctions, and dueling defense drills. In his first visit to Russia, newly appointed Chinese Defense Minister Wang Feng attended the 7th Moscow International Security Conference, accompanied by a delegation of our high-level military officials, emphasizing that his trip was coordinated directly with Chinese President Xi Jinping. Wang said that he had two major messages for Russia at the time when both nations were attempting to modernize their armed forces and strengthen their hands in global affairs in spite of U.S. fears. Said, I am visiting Russia as a new defense minister of China to show the world a high level of development of our bilateral relations and firm determination of our armed forces to strengthen strategic cooperation, Wang said at a meeting with Russia Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu, according to the state-run TASS Russian news agency. Second, to support the Russian side in organizing the Moscow International Security Conference. The Chinese side has come to show Americans the close ties between the armed forces of China and Russia, especially in this situation. We've come to support you, he added. The Chinese side is ready to express with the Russian side our common concerns and common position on important international problems at international venues as well. You see this, family? Y'all see this? This is Russia and this is China. I told y'all. A war is coming. A war is fucking coming. A war is motherfucking coming. But Trump's big mouth dumbass always got a fucking... Like, he took full of him fucking self, man. Trump think everybody's supposed to bow down to his dumbass, and he don't know shit. But it's gonna be the end of the U.S., though, family. It says, Russian and China military leadership meets ahead of the Moscow International Security Conference in Moscow, April 3rd, 2018. The two major powers have pledged solidarity in the face of what they see as U.S. aggression and hegemony. Russian Ministry of Defense. Russian President Vladimir Putin and his Chinese counterpart command what's often considered the world's second and third most powerful armed forces, respectively, behind the U.S., while the Pentagon has managed to retain a comfortable lead against its leading competitors. Moscow and Beijing have coordinated closely as they both aim to close this gap and check U.S. influence abroad. Damn. Told you. I knew some the Russian and Chinese were gonna come together. Cause they was backing each other. So it just made it public and broad and everything. So it says, as Russia showed off its military prowess by declaring victory in the Syrian conflict and boosting its military power across Europe, China has invested in international infrastructure projects, especially across Asia and Africa, and expanding its presence in the Pacific. Both countries argue they are looking to work with and not against the U.S., but Washington has viewed their rise with suspicion and has taken countermeasures against perceived challenges to the international order it has traditionally dominated for decades. Yeah, because these fucking countries is fucking... They tired of that shit. They tired of that shit. They tired of the U.S. bullshit. They tired of them going around just flattening out their fucking chest and doing anything that they want to do. Blow up fucking countries and shit like that and not have to pay for it. They tired of that shit. So, hey, you already know. The U.S. will be falling very, very, very soon. It's falling right now, as we look right now, family. It said, in addition to boosting its own military power in Europe and Asia, the U.S. has portrayed growing Russian and Chinese influence abroad in an assault on democracy. The West has signaled out Russia, especially accusing it of interfering in the 2016 U.S. presidential race and other foreign elections. Washington has also charged Moscow with being behind cyber attacks and physical attacks, including the poison of ex-Soviet intelligence officer Sergei Skripal, who was arrested for being a double agent for London before being released in a 2010 spy swap and moving to the UK. So y'all can see that right now. It says poison relations, Russia and the West. Y'all can see that. So, family, it's about to go down. It's about to go down. It's about to go down. It should, the tension's going to keep rising. It's going to keep rising, family. But, family, I'm going to put the link in the description. And y'all can read the rest of it. And I'll put the link to the article in the description as well. Y'all have a great evening. Love y'all. Y'all donate to my PayPal at firemanpbc@gmail.com. Y'all hit that like button. Y'all smash that like button, family. Y'all smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel. Y'all have a great evening. Love y'all. And I'll be back with another one.